Hello students, great morning. So you must be ready for language class. Well, good enough. Let us begin with one of the easiest topics in English language. That is paragraph writing. Although paragraph writing is one of the easiest topics, but still students find it quite difficult as they don't know the intricacies of writing a paragraph. Let us begin with the basic details of writing a paragraph. A paragraph is nothing but sentences joined in a cohesive manner. They are interconnected and there are a lot of things which can be dealt while writing it. Telling you the parts of the paragraph, it contains the main idea, which is called the topic sentence. It is clearly stated what you want to write in your paragraph. For example, if you're writing paragraph on computer technology, you'll be telling in the very first sentence that what do you mean by computer technology? Or you can start with a view that computer technology has stretched its arms worldwide. Coming next to the part that is supporting part, where sentences explain the main idea. In fact, they develop the idea with logically related details, facts, reasons, and examples. For example, regarding computer technology, you can mention that due to technology, our civilization has grown faster and faster than ever before. You can also add that many different areas such as healthcare, mass medicine, and other areas, in fact, education, medicine, include all these technologies and guarantee proper functioning of each field. The best example you can give right now that you are having e-learning sessions. This is only possible through the help of computer technology. You can add more points according to the word limit given to the question. Usually for paragraph writing, 80 words are sufficient as given in your question papers or for writing. After completing the details, come to the closing sentence that reinforces the main idea. The closing sentence has to be effective as the topic sentence or the main idea. For example, for computer technology, you can end the paragraph in such a way that technology provides a great assortment of benefits like speed, efficiency, and agility to online users all over the world. It has made our world shorter and brief and powerful in terms of time. It has more benefits than flaws. Moving forward, we can discuss the rules that had to be kept in mind while writing a paragraph. The paragraph is about one subject. You need not change the topic. It usually has 3 to 5 sentences in a short paragraph. But when you write 80 words paragraph, you need to write 8 to 10 lines. A paragraph gives supporting details to tell more about the topic, as we have discussed regarding computer technology. And a paragraph is indented. Indented means some part from the margin has to be left while starting the paragraph. A paragraph has a topic sentence. This also we have discussed in the previous slide. And a paragraph has a concluding sentence as well. All of these points I have discussed. Topic sentences and concluding sentences both have significance while writing paragraph. a complete sentence that expresses the main idea of the paragraph, answers questions like why, how, where, and has supporting sentences or relevant details. Basically, the starting of the paragraph and the ending of the paragraph has to be effective. Here is an example paragraph regarding a description of a place, Canada. There are three reasons why Canada is one of the best countries in the world. First, Canada has an excellent healthcare system. All Canadians have access to medical services at a reasonable price. Second, Canada has a high standard of education. Students are taught by well-trained teachers. Third, Canada's cities are clean and efficiently managed. Canadian cities have many parks and lots of space for people to live. As a result, Canada is a desirable place to live. You can see that we have not started with the sentence that there are a lot of countries, Canada is my favorite country, nothing like this. So you need to brainstorm your ideas, give a rough draft before writing your paragraph. And for this, you need to read. Reading is an efficient tool to write paragraph. Before writing, you need to read. Reading is the efficient tool, as I have said. It gives a lot of ideas to your brain. Summarize. Well, good writers revise and edit. After completing your paragraph, you need to see through the details. You need to add details if you want to add some. You need to remove details if you want to remove some. You have to move or substitute some boring words with the exciting words. This all is done before writing paragraph in FAIR. You need to prepare a rough draft which will give you an idea how to write a good paragraph. It doesn't take much time, don't worry. If you practice, if you work harder, if you keep on writing, it will just be an easy call for you. You need to see where you have to capitalize the letters, where you have to use punctuation marks, where you have to use spelling errors. You have to see. Basically, you have to revise after writing your paragraph. So writing process, again, I'm telling you, it's regarding brainstorming ideas, using ideas as rough draft, revising your ideas and then editing, and finally presenting a new, a correct, and a beautiful paragraph, your beautiful, magnificent piece of writing. Thank you for listening with patience. Now, I would like all of you to write a short paragraph in about 80 words on the topic, how do I spend my leisure time? Means free time. Usually it is devoted to a hobby. So get your pens, pencils ready and start writing. Hang on, I'll give you a choice. You can either write paragraph on how do you spend your leisure time, or you can write about today's e-learning session. So you have to write any of them in about 80 words.